Hello, my name is Peter Stokkebroe. I'm from Denmark, and I'm very pleased to have been asked to do a lecture here on the WDSF website on the educational department. And I am so fortunate today that I have a chance to dance with my wife and partner through many years, Kristina Stokkebroe. And we will go through a small routine in cha-cha-cha. And the title of this lecture is How to Create Musicality and Speed in the Cha-Cha-Cha. And that subject is a big one for us because we see generally in the Latin American dancing and in specifically in the Cha-Cha-Cha that speed becomes a priority, which actually makes musicality suffer, and therefore we have less quality and characteristic of the Cha-Cha-Cha when we see the couples dance in all levels. So we would like to go through 2 points today where we are going to talk about some basic technical skills and some theory about how to define a clear cha-cha rhythm and therefore create both speed and musicality in the body. The first thing I'm going to go through to set up the body in order to create speed and musicality is how we function through the body and position the body. So I have 3 points, major points, which I am prioritizing first of all when I teach and when I adjudicate, to see and if I can recognize that the system of the torso of the body is working fluently and with no stress, and you can see that there is a freedom of movement. So we talk about very often that the base, the hip area, the whole pelvic area down to the thighs is a stabilizing and supporting area, whereas very often we would think about the hip area to be an activity area where we try to create hip action. It's done for us too low, and therefore in the cha-cha it becomes heavy and uncharged in the center. So what we're going to do is we're going to have a sense of stability and support from the base, and very important in the buttock area, we open our legs from the back. We have a position where we feel the support from underneath the bum to in order to create a stable plateau for the torso to dance and move in and around. And therefore, we often see the mistake done by couples that they try to create so much hip action and it's done in the bone and it becomes on the outside, the exterior of the body, because they would like to show a good hip action. We believe that a good hip action is a result of a well-functioning center and torso and a stable foundation, so we can see the freedom on the outside from an inside working fluently. And the next part is the torso area, where we say all the activity is done from the diagonal stomach muscles, from the back of the spine, that we have a working area for the muscles next to the spine. They're working actively as close as possible to the spine, so it does not become an exterior, artificial, outside action. So we want to take the activity as close as possible to where the power of the body is, and therefore the exterior will be relaxed. And the last part is the shoulder area, which we consider the frame. And the frame area is where it's so important to be connected on the shoulder blades on the back. So we have a feeling that the shoulder blades push down and out to support your frame and to support your arms. So we have a stable base, a support, we have an activity area, and we have a frame which is creating the style of our institution. So we do not go into a motion where we let the effect go into the shoulder area, the effect of the torso muscles. We create a stylistic or a disciplined finish to the action. So we keep Cuban motion in the center. We are supported well to create that freedom in the center, and then we have a clean, perfect picture on the top part. And there is two possibilities here, and it's a very difficult thing to combine. Either we distort and do too much, so therefore we see, we call it a wriggling, That means that the reaction from the torso goes into the shoulder, and actually it becomes disconnected in the arm to the partner if you're connected. It does also become disconnected to the arms in general if we get too much activity in the shoulder. The other side would be that there's too much stiffness and fixedness about this frame, so there's a misunderstanding of how to carry yourself from the back, so actually it becomes a fixed point, and then we see a blocked body, a lifted chest, which actually has not the expression of the Cuban motion in the center. So to find the right balance is to pick up your spine, to let your ribcage drop, to feel freedom, so you feel a positive forward activity from the back. And then we work from the torso, and then we let that work react into the chest as a natural reaction, and not something which we try on the exterior to produce and show. And if we do it correctly and with the right balance, it will look extremely clear and competitive, and it also looks extremely active in the center. And we will show this later when we do the choreography together. The second thing I'm going to talk about is how to create the speed combined with the musicality in a characteristic way of cha-cha-cha. What we think is the most important for the dancer to accomplish and to understand and learn and train is to get the perfect mix between the speed of a leg action, which is the definition from the knee to the foot, which has a certain speed and an activity and clarity that becomes total clear in the timing of the music. So if we prioritize that, we have a foot speed, and then we have a continuation in the upper body. That contrast between the foot arriving super fast and isolated, and then a body that continues through that, is what we think is the most magical thing about cha-cha-cha. So it has a slickness and activity, but still a continuity in the body. And I would like to talk about two different actions which we feel is very, very important to characterize the cha-cha-cha. We have the walking action, which is a full beat action, where we have a hip action and a work from the body, dancing the hip first in pendulum, then in rotation, a spine which is positive forward and kept lifted between the hip area and the ribcage area. So we have a lift here in order to free up movement. And therefore we have a lot of activity close to the spine because we are lifted up. We pendulum, we rotate, and now at the right time the foot is defining the step with a leg straightening from the knee to the foot, and it rolls under you as a scooping action. Zip. So the foot is placed, but that transition and that arrival is invisible in the upper body. So that is timed perfectly in connection to the weight change. So I flick the foot and I continue my body weight through like there's no effort in this speed in speed of the foot. When I get this combination of foot speed and body action connected together in the right combination, then I can make a choice to create hip speed as well when I choose to. So the first thing is to understand the timing of the hip, how is it going and when is it going. And we have in the duration of the actual step, we have when the foot is arriving, I have a half beat to take my hip through center, starting to pendulum. Then I have a quarter beat to finish the pendulum and to start rotating on the last quarter. So we define it as half, quarter, quarter. And then I can choose to melt it together, blend it. I can choose to have an aggressive attitude towards the hip action. But it's all an artistic choice. But you can see if the dancer is functioning through the body with pendulum and rotation combined with foot placement. If that is run seamlessly, and you can look at the back of the dancer, you can see on the back that it's actually all the time effortless and has a freedom on the outside. The second action we are concerned about in the cha-cha-cha, which we need to characterize the cha-cha, is the stepping action. And it's very important to understand that the stepping action is a total different concept than a walking action. It is a step, meaning that my foot is placed and I have a reaction in the body, and I do not carry full weight to the leg, and I do not make a hip action on that step. So a stepping action becomes a very sharp, a very fast, and very clearly defined difference from the walking action. And therefore, a great dancer and one who has accomplished a lot of skill has noticed and can control and show the difference between a full beat and a walking action, and the contrast in the stepping action. And then the dancing of the cha-cha-cha becomes dynamic without an exterior trying to create effect on the outside. So the contrast is that we do full action and a two and a three and a. Now the cha, cha, a, cha, a, cha. So suddenly we have a total different setup in the cha-cha action, and the timing of the hip is different, and we have a little extra sound to define where the hip is going. It's called a, cha, a, cha, a, cha. We would like to show you in a short choreography how this is hopefully developed to a after many years of practice, and hopefully you can see what I have explained here today to create musicality and speed in an effortless, a mastery feel that everything is under control with no effort. Together with my partner and wife, Kristina, I have done a little choreography to show these qualities I have been speaking about. And this choreography is done and based on partner skill. That means that there's a relationship between a man and a woman, a play. And I think it's very important, and it's a big priority for us, that the essence of cha-cha-cha is kept, that there is a partnering skill to dance a cha-cha. Very often we see that dancers trying to perform with mannerisms and individual work, they actually go away from the essential idea of cha-cha-cha, that is a play between man and woman. And especially choreographically, we see a lot of side-by-side work. We see a lot of detached movement where it's actually two dancers individually dancing without having a physical or emotional connection. We think that physical connection is a very difficult skill, and it shows a dancer on the highest level who can accomplish that. It's much easier to dance alone, so therefore we are very much prioritizing that if you want to be on the very highest level in the world. I would like to present Kristina. Please come. And we would like to go through very slowly this cha-cha routine, which is very short, but just to define the different actions. So the man starts, two, three. He does a rotational slip chassis, which we call it, four and one. We do a slow motion Cuban break, two, three, four, one. Syncopated Cuban breaks, two, three, four. Man slides, one. The lady does a hip lift, one and two. Then she goes three and four and one. So we have a play where we hold the time and suddenly we explode into a cha-cha rhythm again from the hip action. The guy turns. Two, three, four, and slide past the girl. One, looks at the audience to connect to them. He looks at her, and she turns back. He turns back to the audience while she is playing behind his back. He drops forward and he runs around to get back to her. Two and three, four and one. So the guy holds on two, the girl step on two, he turns her on three. Three, hold four, she slides forward and does a ronde, and it's a slow motion feeling, so she kind of holds time, one, two, three. The guy leads her through that action. And then she steps forward, four and one, four and one. And they go now into a open hip twist. Two, three. What's special here is we over-rotated to create more hip rotation and speed in the hip area. And cha-cha, one. Hold two, squeeze through the action. It's a full movement. Hit three, guy drops down, four, and one. They, we meet, two, she kicks, three. Guy goes up, four, step one. Close hip twist, two, three, one, and two. Hold three, four, one. She zigzags, two, and three. She overturns, four, one, two, three, and four, and one. We finish off with two rotational slip chassis. Two and three, four and one. Slow motion again. We would now like to dance this with very slow cha-cha music in order for you to see the definition and the different actions of the cha-cha-cha which we have incorporated in this small routine. Thank you. I'd like to finish off this lecture showing you this piece of choreography with normal speed music. For hopefully you can see the points we have been going through, and we hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you very much.
Cindy, Mama, you understand that? Well, like, I don't understand how you can, cause, like, I've been to, you know, Paris, Peru, you know, I'm in Iraq, Iran, Eurasia, you know, I speak very, very, fluent Spanish, todo da bien chévere. Listen to
that?
Chévere.
Chévere.
Is that right, Mama? Yeah, cause I got my shaking room on the floor.
Everybody's got.